90s camp pop.
A refusal to take things seriously, just reveling in kind of playfulness.
Camps are knowing wink, but you're being crap.
Campily. Campiness, campy.
A neat little package just to put something into that's harmless.
Something so outrageously artificial, affected, inappropriate, or out of date as to be considered amusing.
Since then, camp's been cool, most of the time.
I think a lot of people that are put under the category of camp these days, the way the music industry is, are just desperate to have that categorization so they can appeal fundamentally to a gay audience.
So what remains for pop's lifeless body?
Reanimator camp. Pop zombies brought back to life with an injection of camp.
Look at me. Well, it's not okay. Tonight we ignore all who were reinvented as camp and those who tried just too bloody hard. Instead, we celebrate those who are always camp, pouting pioneers from every corner of the pop universe.
No matter what society or life unleashes on us, people will always want a bit of glitter.
Tranny, basically. I've never known a girl like
you before. No more offensive on the eye than Vanessa Phelps. Never.
Give me the script and I'll do it.
I cannot possibly overemphasized the genius of John Waters and Divine.
The early Divine films were really like trashy and so camp, I mean, so outrageous, not fit to be seen almost, with really obscene acts in them.
Oh my God, almighty! It's from the greatest
lottery I've ever known. The majority of them probably thought it's just some poor old fat bird up there thinking you think you're a man but you're only a boy, and when they realized they felt as though they'd had the wool pulled over their eyes. I don't think he took it particularly seriously, that was the genius of it, but his character overshadowed the record. It was him, it was a soundtrack for his existence.
In 1988, the 47-year-old, 28-stone camp legend died of a heart attack.
When you've been famous since you were 16, there's no going home anymore. You've got to keep on that treadmill. And I think that she has a lot of reinventions.
Cher's most successful incarnation was also her campest.
I met with Cher and I said, you know what, you have a fantastic gay audience and they adore you. And then you keep giving them these macho rock ballads. She said, well, that's what I do. And I said, well, why don't we do a high energy record? No matter how
hard I try. A commercial kind of gayness to teen girls.
Boys with the top off, you get out there and do a few karate kicks covered in baby oil, we'll get the pink pound.
I'm in love with Mark because I think we'd make a very nice couple.
Gary, if you were a chubby chaser, so you had something for everyone.
They gave something back for that pink pound. They gave quality pop music.
And more than a pound or two of flesh. Four.